coming to you. It's Monday, the 2nd of January, 2016. It's a bank holiday here in the UK, so lots and lots of people have got a little extra day off work today. Not everyone, of course. You know, doctors, nurses, people working in bars, hotels. What's that industry called? Not the entertainment industry, the residential, the service industry. Is it the service industry? Hotels and things like that. They're all working, but a lot of people have got a day off. But thank God that the 1st of January has passed. Why is that, you're asking? Because in the Daily Superstore Away Daily Mail yesterday, it says more people die on January the 1st than any other time of year. Now, this is interesting, right? Because, of course, as you well know, we always do birthdays at the end of the show. The way I find the birthdays out is on my Facebook. So if you're on my Facebook, I will know when your birthday is, as long as you've got it entered there, and I will automatically give you a completely free and uncharged birthday message at the end of your at the end of the show, if it's your birthday on that particular day. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that, does it, eh? Does anyone else ring you up and say happy birthday for nothing from a large organisation like United Kingdom Talk? I doubt that very much. Is green and yellow going together? I think it is. It does. This is quite a nice look, isn't it? Green and yellow. Do you know, I think I might use this for tonight's karaoke. Yes, because there's not a lot that goes with this jacket, I tell you. As many people are kind to point out to me whenever I've got this one on, especially Bruce, who comes along to the quiz night, he says, this is my Rupert jacket. I look like Rupert the Bear. Rupert the Bear. Everyone knows his name. Is that calendar crooked? Oh, isn't it? That doesn't hang straight, look. Why wouldn't that hang straight? I don't think they've put the hole in the right place. They haven't put Barry's hole in the right place. How annoying is it? Actually, I know what I can use my gun stapler for. This is my favourite tool, this is. Oh, yes. There's many a day that I've been working somewhere and someone's got their back turned and I've fired a staple directly at their bottoms. Yes, here we go. Let's just put one in here and that will hold it in position. And this will be held in position then for the next 12 months. One moment, please. Selecting straight and look at that. Do I need two? Do you think I should have two? One's enough. No, I only need one. Does that make any difference if I do that? No. Oh, it does, doesn't it, actually? It stops reflecting. Okay, we'll put one there as well. Just a moment. How's that? That's better. Actually, that stopped it reflecting. Look at that. Oh, how marvellous. You kill two budgerigars with one brick. I think that's the correct expression there. Yes, I'm sure that is correct. And I am unanimous in that. Anyway, back to the story. Now, this is interesting because yesterday, January the 1st, I had the most birthdays I've ever read out in a single show. I think it was 27 birthdays yesterday. You know, it's a good job. The show was an hour long. It really, excuse me a moment. Can I just blow my delicate nose? I won't make too much noise. Oh, that's so much better. Oh, that's so much better. It says here, research shows that more people die on January the 1st than any other day, despite the fact that most people spend January fighting off hangovers and sleeping. Was that you? I bet that was you. That was my nephew, Jimmy, that was, and his girlfriend, Charlotte. They were sleeping off hangovers until mid-afternoon yesterday. Shocking. We actually did get Jimmy on the phone yesterday, didn't I? His mother, my sister, I told her to go up the stairs and wake him up, and she did this while we were doing our live show yesterday. Yes, this isn't live, incidentally. A couple of people are putting little messages sometimes on the thing saying, oh, sorry, I couldn't be there for your live show. Well, they're not always live. Some are recorded, some are live, and once the live one has happened, it goes back on there as a recorded one. The way you know it's live is there would be a little thing, I think, in the left or right-hand corner that says, is in red, it says live, or live, I think it just says live or live now, one of the two. If that's illuminated, then you are watching the show live. If it's not illuminated, then you are watching a recording. And, I mean, most stuff on the television is recorded. I don't know if you knew that. Yes, believe it or not. You know when they show Star Trek? I know this is hard to believe, but that is not actually a live as it's happening event. Isn't that amazing? I thought there were actually starships floating around the universe, and it was like a documentary, a live documentary, coming from the USS Enterprise. Did you like that? They actually looked like an Enterprise then while it was going across, didn't it? Anyway, back to the story. A study collected data and found death spikes for the 2 weeks around Christmas and the New Year. And overall, the research found that the day you're most likely to die of natural causes is, ding, 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 January the 1st. So if you're still with us, congratulations. You're here for another year. So am I, hopefully. I'm hoping to be here for at least another 500 years, chatting away in your little earboxes. I really am. Now, I actually nearly... talking about people that were drunk. I mean, again, this was in the Daily Mail yesterday. And it's lots of pictures. I mentioned the bloke. I mean, this fat bloke there. I mean, he's... Actually, he looks even fatter than me, this one. And he's got his... He's got trousers. He's... Honestly, he's got... He's about... He looks too old to have these trousers on for a start. I know you can't see the picture there. But they're skin-tight trousers, three sizes too small. And not only that, they're just below the top of his bum. So you can see the bit sticking out the top where you'd want to put a piece of toast or a letter thunk like that. There's pictures of people fighting, women being sick in the streets, a bloke asleep on a rubbish chip. Dreadful, ghastly people, dear. Ghastly. And I don't think I have ever, ever been like that. I honestly don't think I've been like that. And if you want to see that, just go into Leicester Square in London on a Saturday night. It is shocking. Absolute carnage. I would not want to go there. I would not travel into London if I didn't have a job in London. And that's the truth of it, really. And in fact, even down, I do a place in Maidenhead. Not very often, say once every 6 weeks, once every four, 6 weeks, something like that. And even coming out of there sometimes, you look up the street there, oh, and they're comatosed, some of them. They don't just get merry, they get absolutely comatosed. Anyway, I had a lucky escape with death last week, boys and girls. Now, I meant to tell you this on the show yesterday, but we had so many phone calls and messages coming in, we didn't get the time to tell you. I didn't get the time to tell you, so here it is. Yes, so on... Saturday morning, I think it was. Saturday morning, I thought I'd have a little swim in the morning before my New Year's Eve gig. And I went up the local swimming pool, as I usually do. And there were two people in the swimming side. And there was only one person in the kind of non-swimming side where elderly people, usually if they just want to walk up and down, or people, you know, just having a bit of laugh, maybe families with children, that sort of thing, they go in that side usually. But there was no one in there. There was only the two people who were going up inside in the swimming pool, in the adult swimming lane, and one person in there. So I went in the, what would you call it? I'd call it the children's lane. I went in the children's side because there was only one other bloke in there, and he was one side. I said, I'll take this side if that's all right. He said, yeah, okay. And that's actually the smallest part of the pool, because in that corner are like the steps that you go down. It's not like a ladder. It's like steps that you would go down, and it shortens that part of the pool. And generally, people don't like swimming that side, because the other thing is, as you're getting close to it, that step at the bottom, you have to judge it. Otherwise, you bang your knee on it. And that is painful as you're getting there. So I chose that side, and I'm going. I went down, and then when I come up again, I suddenly observed floating in front of me an electric light, illuminated and plugged in, dear. And there it was. What it was one of the side lights that's in the pool, you know, and obviously it had come loose, and there it was, floating on the pool, connected to the wires. I thought I was going to be electrocuted. I immediately got out my slim and my swimmer type, but I looked like Tom Daly in those swimming trunks. I absolutely... Oh, there is a joke. No, I can't tell you that joke. Can I tell you that joke that the drag queen... No, I can't. I can't tell you the joke that the drag queen... Because, oh, there'll be complaints, dear. There will be complaints. I know that... Oh, shall I... No, I can't tell you, darling. I can't tell you. Anyway, so I got my Tom Daly type body out of the pool. and went to the little door in between kind of reception and the swimming pool. There's a direct door. I have to push a button. Usually it's for staff only, but members, but regular members, long-term members like myself, with a platinum membership card now. I was upgraded to a platinum membership card as I went past 2 years of membership. How fabulous is that? So I said to the governor there, Trevor, I said, oh, Trevor, there's a light floating in here. And he immediately came in and said, oh, I said, am I likely to be electrocuted? And he said, oh, I don't think so. It's low voltage. But you don't know, do you? You don't know. So anyway, I'm in the pool and he's on the edge and I'm assisting him in the DIY repair of this light. Now, as you know, my DIY skills are not really very good. You wouldn't want me to come around and put a shelf. The shelf that this camera here is on has already fell down at the end of last year, and I don't know how it fell down, to be honest. It fell down. Anyway, it's back up again, held together with bits of tape and cotton, and it's still up there. So the kind of round thing, it's kind of on a bracket, and this round thing has got three screws. One, two, three, like that. And he said, are there any holes around the edge? So I kind of put my thing around it because, you know, it would have been ideal if I could have got under, you know, and opened my eyes under the water. But I don't put my head underwater. And I've been swimming now for over 20 years, about 20, 21, 22 years now. I never, ever put my head underwater. Might drown. Don't want to drown, dear. Who's going to talk to you every day if I drown? Exactly. You think someone's going to come in and take over? No, that will be it. I need to be protected. I need government protection doing this programme. Otherwise, who are you going to listen to in the morning? You'll be bored. You'll be bored. You'll have to put on something boring like Sky News. Sky News or something boring like that. Or that woman on ITV. What's her name? Lorraine. I mean, what is she saying? I can't understand a word she's saying, dear. Lorraine in the morning. So, you know, be careful. So we're trying to fit this thing up and I'm feeling around and I couldn't feel any holes. So I said to him, I think what it is, it's like a hole like that and you got to get the screws behind the hole and then these three hold it in. But they all look like they were fully extended. So we're not quite sure. So I'm kind of putting this back in and it just floated back out again. So I said, well, I said, it might be dangerous. Shall I unplug it? I don't think it's wired in. And then I looked more carefully and there is indeed a plug that goes into the back of this thing, you see. And I unplugged it. And now I realised what I was doing. I'm now standing there with this plug that is wired in to something somewhere. We're not quite sure how many volts are going through this thing, right? And the lights are still on. He said, well, I'll go and turn the lights out. I said, well, I better not drop this in the pool now. We might all get electrocuted. I'll hold it here. And it was on a tight bit of wire as well. It was only just above the water. And, of course, every time this bloke was coming past, the waves were coming. I thought, I'm going to die. I'm going to be electrocuted. I'm going to be electrocuted. Anyway, eventually, all the lights went out in the pool. And he came back round. I said, well, I'm going to have to hold this. I can't let it go because it'll just drop into the water. It was so tight, this bit of wire, that it wouldn't go on there. I said, are you just going to leave the lights out? He said, no, I'm not allowed to. We've got to have the lights on or we have to close. And these are the lights within the pool. Now, I don't know why that is because they don't exactly light anything up. You know, those pools under the water. I always thought those lights were simply for decorative purposes. I, incidentally, am for decorative purposes in this studio. I mean, without me, look how plain it looks. Look. I'll just try and get out of the way. Look how plain that looks now. That's not an improvement, is it? And here we are. I am the studio decoration. How about that? Hang on a minute. My chair's got stuck now. Oh, dear. 1 minute. That's it. My chair got stuck. I am the decorations in here, you see. So... taped. He lifted this thing, which was kind of on the wall, on the floor, which was a plastic thing. And in there are connections, which were, of course, rusty. So he undone some of the connections and we left the wire. Eventually, well, the only thing we could do was to put the wire back in the wall drawer and push it in the hole. So that's what I did. And then a technology bloke came. Not a technology bloke, a repair man. Maintenance man. A maintenance man came along and he started having a look at it then. Anyway, so he said, well, you go and have your swings. Thanks for your help, Chris. Well, lucky to be alive, I thought, dear. You know, thanks for your help, Chris. So I swam a bit more, done my 60 lengths, got out. And then I was getting changed. And then Trevor came back in. He's the manager. And he was soaking wet. And he had his T-shirt and shorts. He was soaking wet. What's happened to you? He said, well, I've had to go in the pool and try and deal with it myself. I said, "Want the maintenance man? Oh, no, they won't go in the water." And you can just imagine it, can't you? Actually, I can't remember. It wasn't him, but there is a maintenance man there. He's a miserable git. He really is. You try and, you know, he's one of those people and you try and talk to him, you know, just to have a conversation. And he don't want to say nothing. Oh, yeah, yeah, okay. Why do these people have jobs? Please give us someone to talk to. So that's the story. You know, so lucky to be here. Fortunately, it wasn't actually on January the 1st, that incident. It was just on December the 31st. But nevertheless, I mean, how many volts are going through these things? I mean, Trev said, he said, I think it's low voltage. Well, you don't know, do you? Do you know that for definite? Go on, touch it and see. Touch it and see how low those volts are. There you are, Chris Reardon, helping people in your local community. Any DIY, anything like that you want done, just give me a shout, OK? Oh, I wanted to show you this. This was the light my sister was talking asking me about when I was showing you my Christmas gifts the other day. They got she and her husband, Martin, got me this light. Isn't this fantastic? It may not look bad. This is all metal. It's really good and very, very bright. You ready for this? This will probably do the picture in, but nevertheless, look how bright that. Oh, look! Look at this. Look, look. Star of wonder, star of light, westward leading, still proceeding, star of wonder. We three kings of Orient are. Yes. Oh, actually, if I shine it on the mirror ball, look at this. Look. Oh, that's good, isn't it? Can you see the little lights going around there? Or maybe do it that side. That'd be better. Look at the look. Oh, what a good effect that is. And it's got three settings. There's the very bright. There's the not so bright. And there is red alert. I know that Adam will probably take that little bit and use it in one of his future compilations. You like the red alert, don't you? Look at that. I love the red alert. How does that look on there? Oh. Nothing really. So that was one of my favourite Christmas presents this week, and it's called a Big Larry. Yes, so that's fab. Let me see what I've got to say. Oh, I'll tell you what I was watching the telly the other day, and there was something on the news, something about Russia. I keep going on about Russia all the time. But there was a picture of the Kremlin, and it's the first time, really, I thought, do you know what a beautiful building? Well, it's not one building, is it? There's lots of buildings around there, and they're all very vibrant colours and golden roofs, and there was a very blue. When I say blue, I mean it was really blue, the roof, I think it was, and I sure saw a red colour in there. Absolutely stunning, the Kremlin. There's a place I might like to go and see. But what are they? Have they got vegetarian stuff there? Very different. I mean, I've just been to France a couple of months ago. Very difficult to find anything vegetarian there. No, they like their dead animals in France, don't they? Oh, no, dear. No. Let me see, what else have I got here? Oh, of course, I couldn't see the comet. Do you remember I told you there was going to be a comet next to the moon on New Year's Eve? Well, I couldn't see a damn thing, dear. Completely clouded over. And I got out my binoculars, especially for that. Very, very disappointing. You remember I told you on my Facebook at the moment, at the very top, I think it's the page photo, the one that goes right along the top. At the moment, I've got a thing of Theresa May on there. As you well know, I've got a little bit of a thing for Theresa May. But it does make me laugh, boys and girls. It really makes me laugh. As usual, the usual suspects are on there with political type things. Because they're the usual suspects. And I tell you that's the usual suspects who only point out things when they're not happy with them. They never say anything positive. They only point out negative, like, I don't like that. And we've got two here. Where is it now? one from someone, I won't read the names actually, there's three actually. One bloke says, you can't be serious. Now, he's obviously, that's a political comment, you see. What I've put up there is not political. And if they watched this show, like you do, they would know, wouldn't they? But oh no, no, they just see something they dislike, so they comment straight away. There's another one there says, let's leave the praise of Mrs. May until she has delivered a proper Brexit and has closed the floodgates. There's one there. And then someone attacks him. Someone attacks him. Which floodgates? The ones where millions of UK citizens live in Europe? Oh, no, you need nasty, nasty. Oh, no, you mean nasty foreign people. And then he goes on. He says, I'm assuming this is a joke. Well, they don't, obviously don't watch this video, so they won't know what's going on. And I always find that quite amusing. Should I leave these people as friends or should they be deleted? Delete, 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 delete. What do you reckon? Leave a message under there and let me know what you think I should do. Should it be keep or delete? Make your comments now. Press that button now. Some comments on yesterday's show, boys and girls. Hello to Simon. Simon, he does a lot of lovely comments on there. Simon says, when you do the live shows and we can phone in, can we reverse the charges? Are you serious, man? Reverse the charges? I'm not made of money here, dear. No, you can't reverse the charges. Anything for a free phone call. Honestly, Simon, dear. He says, on the subject of empty pubs, because I mentioned that I went past a lot of empty pubs on New Year's Eve on my way to work. And he says, my pub was rammed last night from 7 o'clock at night until 2 in the morning. I think it depends on what entertainment you put on. And New Year is a week after Christmas and a few people are broke. They certainly are. They certainly are, sir. Good morning to Lily, who says, Happy New Year. Happy New Year to you, Lily. Shania says it was lovely to speak to you on the show yesterday. We did a live show yesterday and it was nice to speak to you as well, Shania, my darling. Thank you to Angela Washington, who wishes us a Happy New Year. Josh Ward, who says, Hi, Chris, Happy New Year. Thanks for bringing a smile to my little face for the start of 2017. That's all right. That's what we're here to do, bring a smile. Nothing's too serious, usually. Sometimes we delve into areas of seriousness, but I like to try and keep it nice and lighthearted most of the time, okay? And, I think that's it, is it? Oh, no, no, we got another comment there. What's that on that? No. That's, I've been tagged in something. That's okay. Good. And that's it. Right, let's do today's birthdays then, boys and girls. Fortunately, not as many as we had yesterday. That 27 birthdays yesterday, my word. Here we go then. Happy birthday today to Chris Marlow. Chris used to do drag and he was very good at it a few years ago. Quite a number of years ago. He was in a group, I think, called ABC, weren't you? ABC drag act. So happy birthday to you, Chris. Don't know how old you are today. Are you as old as me? I'm 53 now. 54 next month. 54 next month. 5th of February. Have you put that in your book? 5th of February. Happy birthday today to Joyce Talking Ocean Chasteen. I think that's how you say it. Chasteen, possibly. Happy birthday, Joyce. All right, my darling. 50. That's a good age. Younger than me, dear. Younger than me. Oh, do you know that sounded like Woody Woodpecker then, didn't it? Younger than me, dear. Younger than me, dear. When the woodpecker knocks... We got a woodpecker outside. Pecks away at that tree. Most annoying during the morning. Happy birthday today to Doug Norman, to Joey Melotti, 66 today. Joey, happy birthday, sir. And happy birthday today to Kenneth Joelsson, who's 49 today. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Chris, Joyce, Doug, Joey and Kenneth. Happy birthday to you. When there's not so many birthdays, I can actually read out the names rather than doing a happy birthday to everyone. More personal, don't you think? More personal. Okay, being Monday, tonight it's karaoke tonight and every Monday night. And that's at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Being a Monday, we have cheap drinks as well. The show starts at 8 o'clock and finishes at 11:30. You want to come and sing a song or two or three? Then fine, please, please come and sing. Or you want to just sit there and watch? That's okay as well, all right? So once again, Central Station, it's karaoke tonight and every Monday from 8 o'clock together with cheap drinks. And it finishes at 11:30. Enjoy your Monday, boys and girls. Thanks for watching and listening. Lucky to be you, dear. Cheerio. We'll be right back.